I'll get started. Let me get started again, so we'll be able to hear Serge. Serge Bromberg is the president of Lobster Films that collaborated with Film Preservation Associates, and I believe bought Film Preservation Associates, and helped realize many of David's the ideas that he and David did together. The restoration tonight that Serge may say a word or two about will be one example of that. I had the privilege of meeting Serge, of seeing Serge's studio in Paris, where he was just finalizing The King of Kings that we'll be seeing tonight, and was impressed with the staff and the joy and dedication that they showed in the restorations that I saw going on when I visited Lobster Films in Paris. So, Serge, thank you so much for, you traveled the longest, I think, to come from Paris to San Francisco.
Thank you. Well, I guess everyone knows us, and I'm very proud to be here and say a few words. The first thing is that David was instrumental in my career. Meeting him was an inspiration. It's probably his fault now if I'm also the president of the French Army Cinema Unit, with the largest collection of military films in Europe. Not fun, huh? Okay. Let me tell you about our first meeting, because I like that story. It's in the mid-80s. I was doing a survey in New York and meeting a collector. I wonder what ever happened with Black Hawk Films. It was at the time when Black Hawk was in the middle of nowhere, and that collector on the East Coast was collecting religious and porn films at the same time. Told me, I don't know, it's someone called David Shepherd in Los Angeles, I believe, who has that. So I canceled my trip back to Paris and took a plane to Los Angeles and called literally all of the David Shepherds in the phone book. There were 12, and only one was the real David Shepherd. Come on, this is not going to work. Only one was a real David Shepherd. Yes, and he answered actually he was away, and he answered in the night before I left. So basically at 11 p.m. I called a number and said, when the man answered, "Are you David Shepherd?" He said, "Yes." I said, "I'm a French collector. I'm leaving tomorrow morning at 8. I've been looking for you. Can I see you in half an hour?" It was the middle of the night. He said, "Oh, of course." And I went there, and the night ended not in a bar, but in the San Fernando Valley, in the middle of all these printers and negatives and everything. And that was the beginning of a wonderful friendship, as Michael Curtis would say. I'll make a very long story short just to tell you two stories. The first of them is about how David discovered the first animated cartoon ever made, Fantasmagorie, 1908, by Emil Cole. David was a student, and his pal of his name was Doublier, and David knew that Doublier was a camera operator for Lumière at the beginning of the century. So he said, "Well, can I meet your grandfather?" And Doublier had the only surviving print of Fantasmagorie. How he did it get the print, we don't know, but it showed that even as a student, David could find that kind of stuff. Now the print is at the Academy. The second thing is you've seen a clip of Precious Images. As you could see, the images are faded, the color is not right, but that's the best they could find, because the camera negative of that film that David produced is lost, or let's say was lost, because David found it in the flea market. So now it's back at the Academy after a rather unknown trip, but back where it belongs. I'll be very, very short. You know how David had many faces. He could be Dr. Jekyll and sometimes probably be Mr. Hyde at the same time. Before we see King of Kings tonight, which David inspired, I think that film was very inspiring to many, many film collectors. I would like to tell you how David tried to plant the seed for newer generations. He, of course, found us and decided that the lobster would be the place where these films would be maintained and newly restored. We have here Emile Mallet, who is the chief technician of Lobster, and he is the future, certainly. We are more and more the past. But in 1993, there was, as we say in French, une bobine de plus, because my daughter Mary was born, and David was his godfather. Her godfather, well, okay, who cares? He was the godfather. And just to, you know, the godfather is supposed to send presents to the newborn baby. So the present was a film, well, of course. And the nitrate original of that film is also at the Academy. And when I received it, I wondered if there was a message in this with this film. So this is the gift from David to Mary, which has since then been shown in many, many places. Every time I show it, Mary tells me, "Hey, remember, it's my print. You owe me royalties." It's a 1906 film, and we're going to see a two-minute clip of it. Thank you, and well, good luck for the King of Kings. You'll love it, I'm sure.
So next would be John.